I am honored to welcome CA Sangeeta Sumesh.
CA Sangeeta Sumesh is a CFO leadership coach contributing by enabling high performance and enhancing financial growth. She is also an independent director on corporate boards. Sangeeta is on a mission to enable, empower, and elevate businesses with the purpose to serve corporate leaders and teams to shine and succeed. She brings along rich corporate experience of 25 years with multinationals, and her latest position was as the Executive Director and Chief Financial Officer of Dun & Bradstreet Technologies. Sangeeta is a chartered accountant, management accountant, and completed executive education from Harvard Business School. She is a high-performance business coach from the International Coaching Federation, TEDx speaker, and best-selling author. Sangeeta is a professional speaker at many national and international events, forums, and corporates on finance, high performance, strategy, and leadership. She believes in value creation for her clients. Married to Sumesh, mother of two, and balances her personal, professional, social, and spiritual life as an art of living practitioner.
Now, let me invite CA Sangeeta Sumesh on the rostrum. May I request your presence on stage to bestow the welcome bouquet, CA Shilpa? CA Sangeeta Sumesh, get high, create synergies with your energies. Over to you, ma'am.
What a beautiful day, a beautiful country, and beautiful people. I'm so delighted to be here amongst all of you. Before I get started, I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge and appreciate the entire organizing committee for not only putting together this amazing and wonderful event, but also they have managed to create the synergy with their energy. So can we give them a big round of applause, please? I like energy, more energy. In fact, can we do better? Yes, thank you, thank you. The energies that we all have, how do we bring them out so that we can create better synergies, achieve the results that we want? So my dear professionals, are you ready to get high? Are you ready to create the synergies? And are you ready to be action takers? Yes. Is that all? Yes. Can I get some more energy? This side, I don't hear. Yes, that's it. I love this. Awesome, awesome. So, let me start off with a little story out here. There was this huge automobile manufacturing company. They had launched their new car. It was very big. It had the latest updated features. They had spent a lot on advertising, created a lot of messaging on social media, and the fans were all waiting to see this new car that was being launched. So the car was ready to be driven out of the garage and to be showcased to an august audience like you. Just then, the car that was going to come out, they realized something. The height of the car and the height of the ceiling of the garage door were almost the same. So this meant, if they have to take their car out of the garage, the ceiling could get scratched or even dented. Now everybody from the press and the fans, everybody is waiting outside. And imagine, just then they realized this. What do we do? All of them started thinking. So somebody said, it's okay, let's just go ahead with the dent and the scratches. Maybe we can do another round of painting. And then somebody else said, what if we break down the garage door? And then there was a lot of this chatter that was going on. Seeing all this confusion, There was a security guard out there. So he quietly goes to the CEO and he says, "Sir, is it okay if I can suggest something?" Now the CEO thinks, illiterate fellow, what does he know? But then he says, "Okay, I have nothing to lose now. Yeah, tell me what you want." So he says, "Sir, can we just deflate the air in the tire? So the height of the vehicle comes down by a few centimeters. We take it out and then we inflate it." And that's what they did. My dear friends, what did you learn from this story? What did you learn? I'd like to hear from you.
Learn from everybody.
Learn from everybody. Absolutely right. And not just that, you create synergies, right? That's how, irrespective of whatever level you're in, you can still create synergy with whoever, wherever, if you're driven towards achieving your solutions that you want. So, let's start with why. Like my previous speaker rightly mentioned, get to know your why. So why create synergies? Why do you think we need to create synergies? Anybody? Why is this seminar even themed as synergy? Achieve the common goal, absolutely right, yes. So if you were to look at it, we are living in a world of collaboration. It's no longer competition. We are seeing how everybody can collaborate together and achieve the desired results. So collaboration is the key. It's learning, like you rightly mentioned. How can we learn from each other? How can we grow further? That is going to help you. Solutions, right? We all want solutions to our challenges. So how can we get the desired solutions that we want? We also establish connections. Connections, you know, like how he rightly said, the heart-to-heart connection, the care that you want, right? So you establish your connections, and of course, you get better results. Better profitability for businesses, better growth, and that's what drives us all together. And as chartered accountants, we are also keen to get greater financial performance, and that is what helps us, and that's exactly the reason why we need to have synergies among ourselves. Having said that, we all want to create synergies, but then there are challenges. Challenges that come in the way of us attaining these synergies. I'd like to talk about these challenges, one at a macro level, another at a micro level. But before I tell you about the macro challenge, I want to narrate a little thing that happened to me. A couple of weeks ago, my shoulder was troubling me. I couldn't lift my hand. I couldn't move. I couldn't drive. I couldn't serve myself. In fact, I wasn't even sure if I'll be able to make it here today and meet all of you. Now, how do you think that made me feel? I felt I'm weak. Because these things, normal things that we take for granted, right? I couldn't do any of them. I felt anxious because I didn't know how long it was going to last. Will I be okay? I had all these questions in my mind. I felt, what is happening? What is this? Right? I had no clarity on what was happening. I thought it was not something that simple. And I didn't understand why suddenly it caused it. What happened? I had no idea. And my dear friends, the reason I'm sharing this is where we are right now. I'm sure we all have heard of VUCA, but it's no longer the VUCA world, especially post-pandemic. We are into the BANI world, right? Where it's brittle, anxious, non-linear, and incomprehensible. So what does this mean for businesses? It creates an illusion of strength, an illusion of control, an illusion of not predictability, and an illusion of knowledge. And because of this, we'll not be able to get to where we want. And if you notice, BANI has a lot to do with emotions. Because how do you feel when you feel brittle? How is it when you feel anxious? Do you feel good? Similarly, you don't feel good when it's non-linear and incomprehensible. So BANI has a lot to do with emotions. So now you may ask, how do we get over and combat this BANI? Now, this exactly is what happened. How many of you have heard of RPG Group, right? The Seat Tires, Zensar, the group companies. They have about 6 or 7 group companies. And this was the challenge that they were facing. They wanted to see how they can get over this. What are we supposed to do and get the kind of results that we wanted? So I did a 2-day offsite workshop for them on seeing what can be done. Now, one thing that really stood out from this workshop was, they said, we all have to be business partners, right? Because by business partnering, you're partnering with everybody in the organization. All of you are working towards common goals and achieving the results that you want. And therefore, it's crucial and important for everybody to synergize together and be a business partner. So how does one go about? Now, I'll quickly take you through the 2-day workshop that I did for them. I'll quickly take you through on how to combat this bani. So the first was building the culture, the right culture, a culture of high performance. Now, are you able to harness the energy of the entire team? It shouldn't be just one or two people are working. How can everybody bring together and contribute to the growth of the business? Is there a culture of learning, right? Is there a culture of continuous improvement? Is there a culture where people have the freedom to express themselves without being judged for the fear of failure? Because the fear of failure many times stops us from achieving what we want to. So is that possible to build this sort of a culture in your organization? And then, of course, emotional intelligence. I don't have to stress the importance of that because it's all about the bani, right? And, of course, is there a culture of learning? And what is the outcome that's been expected? So what sort of culture, my dear friends, do you have in your organization is something I'd like you all to think about. Next is to appreciate. It sounds very simple, but tell me, who doesn't like to be appreciated on a job that's well done? How would you feel if you were to be appreciated saying, hey, you did a fantastic job? Little things, you know, that make a lot of difference. Small things like acknowledging and appreciating your co-workers, saying, hey, thank you for giving me the report on time. Thank you for enabling me to achieve my result, my goals faster. As long as we can appreciate and support each other, this feeling of anxiety then reduces, right? And then nurture. What do you nurture? Nurture psychological safety. What is psychological safety? Can your team members be themselves when they are with you? Can they feel free to tell and express themselves, their point of view, their perspectives, without being the fear of being judged or ridiculed, right? Can they just express themselves freely? That is psychological safety. So as an organization, can you nurture the concept of psychological safety amongst your team members? Next, insights. You know, the insights. You know, look at the collective knowledge in this room. There's so much of knowledge in this entire room, right? Now, if each of us can share insights with each other, that makes a huge difference. And that's what I did with the RPG group, because there they had, you know, as I mentioned, there were about 6 different companies. One had developed their technology very well. So they were able to help the other companies by sharing their insights. The best practices amongst each of the companies, they started sharing, and that's when they discovered, oh, there's so much of synergy that's possible and we have been missing out on it for so long, right? So is there a way all of you can share insights with each other? That is what it is. So if you want to turn over this bani, right, and move to greener pastures, how do you combat bani? I say combat a bani with another bani. What is it? If it's brittle, build a culture of high performance. If there's a lot of anxiety, start appreciating. If it's non-linear, nurture psychological safety. And if it's incomprehensible, start sharing your insights. And that, my friends, will make a lot of difference. Because you know what I say? Bani, 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 it's not funny in a macro world, right? So that is how you manage to combat a bani with another bani. Now let's look at it from a micro perspective. What are some of the specific challenges that you face in your workplace? and how can we get over them, right? So I'll give you 30 minutes. I'd like you to discuss with the person next to you and just share what are the challenges you are facing in creating synergies in your organization. So very quickly, in 30 seconds, I'd just like you to exchange your viewpoints. Our time starts now. Please go ahead. Thank you. All right, let's come back here. So before I came here, I spoke to about 12, 13 different leaders from Oman to understand their viewpoints and their perspectives on what are the challenges that are coming in their way to that prevent, or rather that they're not able to get the synergy that they want. So I got a lot of different answers, ranging from insecurities, working in silos, unable to see the big picture. However, there were three things that were more or less common that stood out from many people. And since we don't have time, I'm not going to take you through everything. We're just going to be focusing on three challenges. What are they? What is CSR? Yes, corporate social responsibility, but that's not the CSR I'm going to talk to you about. The CSR is, C stands for communication, S is the skills, and R is the relationship. So we are going to be focusing on these three things. Let's start off with communication. Let me again share a little incident out here. A CEO of a large organization, he was mandated by his board to go and open a sister company in the US because they wanted to explore the American market. So what did he do? He went to the US, he poached one of the top sales heads from the competitors and appointed him at a very high package. And then he took a co-working space as the office for him. And then he just outsourced all the other functions, finance, legal, admin, etc. And he just told the sales head, listen, it's your duty to, you know, grow the sales and get us business. Now, fast forward about 2 years. What do you think happened? The sales head quit in a jiffy. All the time, effort, and the money and the resources that were invested went completely a waste because there was not a penny of sales that was generated. Now, if you were in the board of that company, what would you be telling the CEO? Fire, right? That's what most people will think and do. However, this board thought differently. They wanted me to coach him to see what he could have done better, what were his learnings, and what is it that he should have avoided, because they wanted him to explore some other geographies as well. So during our coaching conversation, his awareness levels increased a lot, and what he shared through a coaching conversation is what I'm going to share with you now. So the first thing he said was, I have been a coach to this person. However, I should have avoided a lot of things. What should I have avoided? So he said, I was actually ignoring the keywords and the emotions. Now this sales head used to tell me, oh, I'm so frustrated, you know, I don't feel good and so on. And I never used to pick up on his emotions and I never addressed them. You see, that is also communication. I wasn't really observing what he was doing because I thought, oh, it's your responsibility. You have to do everything. And I was just sitting back and I wasn't doing much. He said, I was sometimes interrupting what he said. I was just being rude to him. And I was abrupt, which is not how I should have behaved as a leader. He said, I was distracted with my other things in the Indian market and therefore not paying attention to him. I was very biased in my views. And also, I was not displaying my empathy towards him. And nor was I listening properly. I rather was doing selective listening. You know what is selective listening? You listen to things only you want to hear. And the rest of it, you just shut it away. So he said, I could have been a much better leader. I could have communicated a lot better with him, and I think those were my big mistakes. Now, talking about listening. Listening is also part of communication, and we are all normally very poor listeners. So how can you do better in your listening skills? That makes a huge difference. Now, these are some key areas how you can improvise your listening skills. Now, imagine if somebody were to come and tell you, oh, you know, I'm so excited. This happened. I met this person. I was, and you're like, oh, yeah, okay, so. See, you're not reflecting their feelings. Imagine if you were to go and somebody behaved like that with you. You don't feel good, right? So these are key aspects of better communication. So for effective communication, there are three V's that you need to remember. That is visual, verbal, and vocal. Visual, because now imagine I'm talking to all of you and then I say, yeah, create synergy with your energy. You're not going to be paying attention to me. Similarly, my verbal, you know, if I say synergy, maybe we can try. Let's see if it works out. Doesn't work. And similarly, my vocal, if I tell you energy, okay, let's do energy. Without any energy, it's not going to work, right? So remember the three V's, and here I would like to share a very wonderful example that happened to me. Remember, I was talking to you about my shoulder, right? So I went to an orthopedic, a highly experienced, one of the best doctors in Chennai. And he's just about 85 years young. So I go to him, and then I went to him with my X-ray report. And he looked at it, and he said, he diagnosed it as condition A. Whereas the X-ray report said it was condition B. So I was a bit confused, and I asked him about it. So immediately what he did, he picked up the phone, put it on speaker, and spoke to the junior doctor who had given this report. He asked him, he said, doctor, this X-ray of Sangeeta, what do you observe in it? So the junior doctor says, yes, this is what it is. And then he said, the senior doctor, he says, what does this mean? So he says, ah, this means it's condition A. Oh, thank you so much, doctor, for guiding me. And he hung up. And I was shocked because such a senior person being so humble and not pointing out his mistake. So I said, doctor. And he says, you have to communicate with a lot of tact and diplomacy. He said, I wanted to educate him because if he doesn't know, he's going to be misguiding others as well. And a lot of other doctors rely on these X-ray reports. And of course, I didn't want to offend him and then say, hey, you know, you've diagnosed it wrongly. This is not what it is. And of course, I wanted to confirm your question as well. So you see, in the same thing, he managed to accomplish everything. And that is effective communication. So how are you communicating with your team members? Because your objective is to get your things done. You don't really want to be pointing fingers to say, hey, you know, this is not right and stuff like that. So that is very important. And then, oops, let's move on to the next, which is on the skills. Now, here again, I'd like to tell you a little incident. I was coaching the managing director of an organization, and he had a clear mandate to increase the profitability of his business. Now, he realized he was not able to tap in to the potential of his team members. He was not able to get the synergy of them because he said, I lack in my leadership skills. And that's something I want to work on and improvise. And at the same time, I also want my team members to start contributing better because there was a lot of attrition and he had a whole lot of challenges with his team. So what did he want to do? So while I coached him on improving his leadership skills, brainstorming, like again the previous speaker said, was something that came out as an emerging thing. Many times, just when we sit together and talk, a lot of ideas come up. So you could brainstorm amongst yourself, or you could even engage an external person who could facilitate you to brainstorm on different areas. And what about the challenges that your business is facing? You could see how you want to overcome them. So brainstorming is something that's important to have better skills. We all have heard of feedback, but have we heard of feed forward? What is feed forward? Now, feed back is a postmortem. Whereas a feed forward, you tell them up front, hey, this is the kind of the report that I want. These are my expectations. I want you to deliver this in this manner before this date. Being clear and articulating it to your team members, then you know you save time. It doesn't have to keep going back and forth. And therefore, with feed forward, you're helping them to develop their skills better. So you need to develop your skills on feed forward so that you are helping your team members to achieve the results you want. And then you have on skill development. There are umpteen ways you can develop skills. Only thing is your interest and keenness to improve your skills. Umpteen ways, like I said, it could be on-the-job training, online courses you have like Udemy and many others which offer online courses, social media, you know, apart from entertainment. You have your YouTube channels, you have Instagram, many others that offer a lot of social media you can learn from. Books, of course, are a great source of knowledge. You can have your workshops, mentoring, coaching, whatever, and these will help the skills to develop better. Before we proceed further, I'd like a small activity I'd like you all to do. I'd like you all to rub your palms together for about 15 seconds, nicely. Now slowly move them apart, like about 5-10 centimeters difference. Can you feel the energy? Just move your palms lightly and you can feel the energy. We all are made of energy. And there's energy or the prana around us, right? Now, what happens if the energy is low? You don't feel good, you feel negative, you feel depressed, and in worst cases, you feel suicidal as well. When your energy is high, you feel good, you feel positive, you are enthusiastic, you are lively. And this energy makes a lot of difference. And that is what is going to be related to the topic I'm going to talk about next. Energy. So you may ask me, if you know, having low energy, how can I make my energy better? How can I be on an upward energy? Now, I understand there are four sources of energy. Food, sleep, breath, and meditation. Food and sleep, of course, most of us take care. But it's the breath and the meditation sometimes that's being ignored. So if you want to enhance your energy levels, see how much you want to focus on these four areas. Now you may ask me, so what do you do about it? So I've been into Art of Living, simple breathing exercises for the past 18 years. Every single day I ensure I do it. So see what works for you. As long as you're able to keep your energy at a high level, ensure what works for you and you're always on the high that you want. Now why am I telling you this? Is the next topic we're going to discuss is on the relationships. Let me again share something interesting here. I was coaching the head of finance of a large European group. And this is what our conversation looked like. Mr. Head of Finance, what is stopping you from creating the synergy you want with your group CFO? He's your boss. You should be creating synergy with your boss. Oh, my boss. That man doesn't know anything. You know, he doesn't even know what is a variance analysis. He can't differentiate between a positive or a negative cash flow. He doesn't know anything about the Indian tax rules. I don't respect him. Why should I have synergy with him? I'm not interested. Okay. So tell me, what happens if you don't create the synergy with him? If I don't create the synergy with him, he will soon go back to Europe. He will lose his job. They may even fire him. And for all you know, I may become the CFO. You never know that. Oh, really? Yes, yes, why not? But actually, if he is looked upon as a failed, you know, in his mission, they may tell me also, no? Because I'm supposed to be supporting him. So So, well, actually, I may also lose my job. Maybe I'll look out for another job. But even that, you know, if they were to track my record and how it was, that'll again be a black mark in my career. Oops, what do I do? Great realizations. What do you think happens to the business? Oh, the business will suffer. We will have a lot of losses because, you know, we have a lot of income tax cases that's going on. And that means I may not be getting my increment and my bonus. Well, actually, not just me, my entire organization, everybody's pay gets affected. Thank you so much for making me realize on why it's important to have synergies. My friends, that's exactly what happens. Now, if you don't create that synergy that you want within your teams, it has a ripple effect. Everything is impacted, and like the karma, it comes back right to you as well. And therefore, if you want to set aside all this, you need to ensure you're creating the right synergy with your people. So how do we go about it? Do you know what this stands for? WIFM? Yes, what's in it for me? Now this me is not just, you know, one person, but it's the other person as well. Because unless you know why you're doing what you're doing, how will you get to where you want? Right? And therefore it's important. Here again, I'll give an example. I was coaching one of the head of internal audit in the Gulf region. He had a new boss, a very tough and challenging boss, and he wanted to impress him and, you know, be in the good books of his boss. So he asked me, what do I do? So I said, what's in it for you and what's in it for the boss? Why would he want to work well with you? So if you're able to address both these aspects of why in you and your other person, your relationships get better. I have another small activity for you. I'll give you 30 seconds. Go and meet anybody you want in this room and meet them like you're meeting your best friend after 2 decades. How will you go and greet that person? Very quickly, you can go and meet anybody you want in this room. 30 seconds, your time starts now. Thank you, settle down, thank you so much, please settle down. Now, what were my instructions? I said, you can go and meet anybody in this room. While a lot of you interacted with each other, nobody came here to meet me. Why was that? Because I was here in the stage, I just gave instructions and I never came and mingled. Now, supposing I had come down the stage and then wished and greeted all of you, I'm sure you would have reciprocated. And that's what happens in businesses as well. If you don't go and meet the person and connect with them, it becomes a big barrier. Ego. That's what murders relationships. Now, I had also conducted a leadership workshop for the CXOs of different organizations, CEOs, CHRO, CFO, CMO, and others. And they shared a very key learning in their workshop. They said, you know, we are leaders, but we are very poor listeners. We don't appreciate. We don't learn. We don't have the right mindset. And what is stopping all of that? Is our ego. Oh, we think I'm a leader. I know it all. Why should I go? Why should I do this? And that's exactly stopping your leadership. So ego, see if you can just kick it out of the door and connect, start connecting heart to heart with people for better relationships. And then, of course, like I mentioned at the beginning, the psychological safety. How do you go about building psychological safety? Building trust, which was again touched upon by the previous speaker. You lead with empathy, right? Because we all lack empathy. Empathize with your people, being non-judgmental with them. Encourage them to be their authentic self, right? They don't have to put up a facade in front of you. Contribute, very important, contribute to their well-being. How are you helping them? How are you contributing to their growth and their wellness? That's important. And of course, another important thing is to treat with respect and dignity. By doing that, you are actually nurturing the psychological safety. So my dear friends, are you ready for challenges? Yes, awesome, I love it, okay. So, we spoke about Bani. We also spoke about the three challenges. How do you think, behave and act with the communication skills and relationships to get better? Now my request for you is to pick up two or three areas that you think will help you to better the synergies that you want. So that's the challenge all about, and I would urge you to pick up a buddy, an accountability partner, whoever you want, whoever with whom you synergize better, so that you're accountable to each other to see how you're progressing. So, oops.
Does it include you?
why is this gone back? This technology, okay. Yes, yes, so don't worry, we'll get over that. So get yourself an accountability partner, see what you would like to do, because that is going to help you better. And I'm going to give you a framework for it, right? Who's this? Tom. Right? So Tom is the acronym you need to remember, where T is the time frame. By when do you want to accomplish what? O is the objectives, why you want to do what you want to do. And M is the measure, because unless you measure it, you'll not be able to progress. So keep this term in mind, and I'm also going to gift you a workbook around this. So this is the downloadable link. You could probably click a picture of this. It's valid for 4 days. I will also probably share it with CA Unmesh Ji. He can also share it with all of you. Download it, and it tells you how you can go about it, right? So, yeah, okay, these are my books. This is a spiritual thriller, A Glance at the Unknown. It won me an award as one of the 100 inspiring authors of India. Thank you. And then I had What the Finance, which is a national bestseller. Get High is how to coach yourself for high performance in your work. Where's the Moolah is about financial growth hacks for better business profitability. And hard and soft copy are available. And of course, since you guys have been amazing audience, I'm happy to connect with all of you. And if you want, I could share the soft copy of the first two chapters of the book, Get High, which is in line with a lot of things that we discussed today. So, my closing remarks to you would be this. Now, if you want a flower to bloom, you don't blame the plant. You see if it has the right environment, the right sunlight, the right water, the right nutrients, minerals, whatever it takes for the flower to bloom. And my friends, to create your synergies, you need to focus on what you need to do to get the solutions. Not focus on the problems, but focusing on the solutions that you want to create the synergies. And by doing that, you're building better synergies. Okay, so before that, may I request you all to please stand up just for 2 minutes. I'd like you all to put your hand to your heart and repeat after me. I commit to communication skills relationship improvement, acting with awareness, remembering my why, elevating myself and the people around me. And by showing this care, you are building the synergies that you want, a culture of high performance that you want, enabling better profitability, better economic growth, and making Oman a great place to work. Thank you. Thank you so much. Wishing you all the very best. And get high and stay on the high that you want. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for being amazing audience.
With great pleasure, I convey CA Sangeeta Sumesh our sincere appreciation for her vision and leadership. Thank you, ma'am. Let me call upon CA Mubeen Khan, past chairman of ICAI Muscat Chapter, to felicitate CA Sangeeta Sumesh.